The Straw Hat Pirates are the central figures of One Piece and the key reason why the series has been able to sustain decades of serialization. It is with very careful and very well thought out planning that Oda must select which characters to incorporate into the key fabric of his manga. Throughout the years, there have been many opportunities for other characters to have become permanent members of the Straw Hat Pirates, which would have completely reshaped the way we see One Piece. So today, we're going to honor these figures, as well as compose an alternate reality crew. Here are the top 5 characters who were almost Straw Hats. Number 5. Zombie Tree and Zombie Unicorn. Okay, so we're starting off this list with what I think is one of the greatest missed opportunities in the series. While wandering through Thriller Bark, Luffy stumbled across a zombified tree and a unicorn drinking together. A fairly pleasant and even civil scenario, all things considered. They were just minding their own business, and in comes a rampaging Monkey D. Luffy, stars in his eyes. The pair were successfully caught after attempting to flee from the Straw Hats, and in a classic Luffy moment, he immediately asked them to join his crew. Although it should be noted that he got cut off by Zoro and Sanji before he could complete the request. I suppose that invalidates the entire thing, but hey, that's why this is the top 5 characters who were almost Straw Hats. The whole situation is kind of a parody on when Luffy immediately asked Brook to join the crew several chapters earlier, and was possibly meant to throw us off the scent that Brook was definitely joining. Still, can you imagine just how awesome the series would have been if Zombie Tree and Zombie Unicorn had become permanent crew members? In fact, let's have a brief glimpse of what that reality would look like. Now, Brook would still be a member because he was asked to join before the zombies, so they would just add to the crew as we know it. Ah, now that's the reality I want to live in. Number 4. Iceberg. That's right, the mayor of Water 7 was approached to join Luffy's crew when they were looking for a shipwright. Luffy was exceptionally impressed with his knowledge and respect amongst the shipbuilding island. He then spared no time inviting Iceberg to become a pirate with him, to which Iceberg instantly, yet respectfully, declined. However, he did offer Luffy the choice of any of his shipwrights provided they were enticed by the offer. And Iceberg probably would have been an awesome crew member. He's highly capable and could have built an amazing ship, but his combat abilities are a bit lacking. Not that that's ever stopped people joining the Straw Hats before, though. His serious demeanor probably would have found a friend in Nico Robin, and he'd likely act as another voice of reason for Luffy. Unfortunately, if Iceberg had joined the crew, it would almost certainly mean never getting Franky, as there would have been no need for a shipwright. Now that's a shame. However, in this reality, we would have never known how awesome Franky is anyway, so here's to Iceberg! Number 3. In a very similar situation to Iceberg, Luffy also invited Dr. Kureha to join his crew when they were looking for a doctor to treat Nami on Drum Island. This invitation was met with a swift kick to the face, primarily because Luffy had called Kureha Grandma while presenting her the offer. She then proceeded to say that she was far too young to be called that, being a mere 130 years old. Oh, and also she believes that being a pirate is a load of crap. But oh my god, just imagine if she had joined. Her volatile nature would play perfectly into the crew dynamic. Often hitting Luffy as a gag. Her medical knowledge is second to none, far outclassing even Chopper, at least when he was introduced. And that brings up an unfortunate point. If Kureha had joined, in all likelihood, Chopper would not have. So we'd be trading our key mascot character for a rad granny. I don't know, it might have worked. I think somebody so old and wise, yet spry and volatile, would have been a really interesting addition to the crew. Alas, it was not meant to be. Number 2. It's the guy in the chest, Gaimon! Having appeared at the dawn of One Piece, Gaimon features in the manga's only single chapter side story. Luffy takes a shining to him, invites him to join, but Gaimon declines, having found peace on his tiny island. Now these were the days when Luffy had only just begun to gather his crew, and you know what? If Gaimon had joined, then I doubt anybody would have thought weirdly of it at the time. In fact, given that Kureha took Chopper's spot, Gaimon would have become the mascot character. I mean, just imagine the Straw Hat's adventures with Gaimon. Like that time Usopp and Gaimon took on Mr. Four and Miss Merry Christmas. Or when Gaimon assaulted Enies Lobby along with the rest of the Straw Hats. And really, who could forget Gaimon's first bounty of 50 berries? Classic Gaimon. Oh, what a world we could have lived in. But there's still one more potential Straw Hat we need to examine. Number 1. And could it really have been anybody else? Nefertari Vivi is arguably the only serious candidate in the entire story who was so close to becoming a Straw Hat. Vivi travelled with the crew throughout the entire Baroqueworks saga, incorporating Whiskey Peak, Little Garden, Drum Island, and ultimately, Alabasta. She was in the story as a main character for a huge chunk of time. Hell, when I think about it, she actually started travelling with the crew before Chopper joined. Vivi fit perfectly into the established crew dynamic, and provided a much needed increased female presence, which would later be filled by Robin. Luckily, if Vivi did join, I don't think that would have stopped Robin joining, so we don't have to sacrifice anybody to bring her aboard. However, in one of the most iconic moments of the series, Vivi tearfully said goodbye to the crew as she decided to embrace her position as Princess of Alabasta and lead her broken country into a new future. It's implied that both she and her duck, Karu, are honorary members of the Straw Hats, but that doesn't stop us envisioning what it would be like if she were a proper Straw Hat. And there you go, the top 5 characters who may have been Straw Hats in the alternate reality of if they had joined. If you enjoyed this video, then please feel free to like, favorite, and subscribe. And I'll see you next time for another One Piece Top 5.